so, HALCON and random bin picking. What is the role? Which role plays HALCON in the random bin picking? First of all, I would like to show you the concept of HALCON as a toolbox. And in the next step, I will guide you through 3D vision in HALCON. And I will go a little bit deeper into pick and place applications in 2D, in two dimension, and in 3D animation. So let's start with HALCON as a toolbox. HALCON is a comprehensive toolbox. It does not include only the image processing library, but all the surrounding topics as well. So it starts from the image acquisition interfaces. It has also the possibility to port the application to a device such as a Jetson board and so on. And it includes also HDevelop as a prototyping tool for writing applications, language interfaces, so you can export HDevelop code into your final language, such as C# or C++. And obviously, the image processing library, which is the centerpiece of HALCON's toolbox. Let's have a look a little bit deeper into the image processing library. So, It includes calibration modules, it includes matching modules, data code, OCR, metrology, 3D vision, 3D metrology, and so on, and deep learning. So you see, it's a huge variance of different kind of technologies that covers HALCON. And this is also one aspect of HALCON. It has a large flexibility. And also in 3D. 3D covers different kind of aspects. So first of all, it covers all the functionalities in order to calibrate different kind of setups, such as single camera calibration, multi-view camera calibration, sheet of light settings, and so on. And obviously, then you can also reconstruct point clouds based on the calibration information. This is the second aspect within the 3D module of HALCON's toolbox. And finally, the 3D processing. 3D processing includes, for instance, 3D metrology, object localization, pre-processing, and processing of different kind of point clouds. The applications in focus are, first of all, height image applications, such as reading text and numbers on height images, height measuring or check filling, for instance, of a cookie box, or defect detection in surfaces, such as scratches and bumps. Then obviously also counting and the check presence application can be covered. Those kind of applications usually requires only height information. And now let's come to the application that require fully 3D space information, such as measuring in 3D, volume measuring, area, and so on. Surface comparison. So you have a ideal object, a CRD model, for instance, and you have the point cloud, which is the acquisition, the scan of the object to be inspected, and then you can find defects or deviations. And then the coplanarity check, a standard application for which HALCON is can be used as well. And finally, random bin picking. Those last four kind of applications requires the fully 3D information of a point cloud. And obviously, there are much more applications that can be covered by HALCON. But let's say those are the main 3D applications that are in the focus of HALCON. When we come to random bin picking, what is the customer journey? So it starts always with planning and simulation. So first of all, you simulate the cell, and the better you can simulate it, the cost effective will be the realization of the random bin picking application. Then you can finally choose the setup. You can set up the communication. You can calibrate the sensor or the camera to the robot and so on. You can do the object localization, the collision avoidance or the trajectory planning. And finally, you visualize the results. Which part does cover HALCON? So it's basically the middle one. It starts with the communication, it performs the HA calibration, and finally the object localization. With respect to the communication, HALCON offers the possibility to communicate with all the most relevant 2D cameras or 3D sensors in the market, in the industrial market. And obviously, and this is one a key focus of MVTec, is the standardization, such as Genicam, GigiVision, and USB Vision. And similar is, this is the acquisition of the data, but the case is similar also to the of the communication of results via, for instance, digital I/O. So here, different kind of protocols are available: UPCA, Fieldbus, bus, and Ethernet, and obviously also sockets. So HALCON basically covers the complete application. So you can write it in HALCON, and then you can port it, for instance, to a Jetson port. So let's come back to the customer journey. So this was the communication, and here you see also HALCON is completely hardware independent. And with respect to the object localization, this is the focus here in the 3D vision part of HALCON. Here you can see a huge flexibility, and this I will show you later also on some edge develop examples. So let's focus on the object localization part of a random bin picking application. So here, for instance, this is the simple case, maybe the 2D case. Here, for instance, you have a plane. The plane can be, for instance, a tray, a conveyor, a feeder, or else. And some plane objects are provided by this conveyor, for instance, can also be perspectively deformed. And then you have to calibrate the 2D camera. You have to calibrate the robot with the 2D camera. And then you can apply different kinds of functionalities depending on the which kind of objects needs to be found. Which situation is there? Is there high noise? Are there many textures and so on? So you have the shape-based matching technology, the NCC, you can use blob analysis and so on in order to optimize your application or the object localization part of your application to exactly your requirements. And this is what I would like to show you now in edge develop. So in order to do so, I prepared already a script. It is this one here. So what I will show you is the use case of a feeder. A feeder is usually equipped with a backlight illumination, and objects are fallen on the feeder, and then there's some vibration, and the objects are somehow separated a little bit. And then the vision needs to estimate the transform, the 3D transform. And this can also be done by 2D, reduced to a 2D problem. So first of all, we read in the image, that's this one here, and then we define a tablet, this screw here. So we draw a rectangle. This is all. This is the offline part, which is done one. And then we can also define some quiet zones. This is the quiet zone where the gripper is able to grasp the object for placing it in a defined position. And then we just call the operator create shape model. We initialize the clutter feature, and then we can localize the objects. So I used a very low clutter contrast score because I do not want it at any or mostly no non other screw is disturbing the quiet zone, but it is obviously also possible to increase this score, and the results would be as follows. So also such kinds of objects can then be found. So let's have a look at some other images, like this one here. And you see the algorithm works perfectly robust and accurate and fast. This is this 2D case. Now, I would like to come to this 3D case, which is the most challenging and the more interesting challenge. So this is the random bin picking. What are the requirements? First of all, you require a 3D sensor, a factory calibrated 3D sensor, or you generate the point clouds based on HALCON's 3D reconstruction algorithm. Then you calibrate the 3D setup with the robot, and that's all. Then you have plenty of different possibilities in order to localize the objects or to estimate the 3D transform. So it starts with the surface-based matching, the standard one. It is the point cloud matching. It is a rule-based algorithm. So far, there's no deep learning integrated in it, but this will also change. Then we have also the deformable surface-based matching in case that you need to localize a deformed object such as apples, banana, and so on. And then the edge-supported surface-based matching in case you have objects with reduced 3D information, such as, for instance, flat objects, primitive fit, and the generic box finder, and much more different technologies. The generic box finder is a technology that allows you to find boxes of different sizes without any knowledge, or without, let's say, very reduced knowledge about the shape of the box. And this is what I would like to show you, also in HDevelop. So it is the next script here, this one here. So to press F5. Now the first scene is here. So it is a 3D scene, point cloud. The boxes are localized. And so what is required in order to do this? First of all, I did some smaller blob analysis in order to reduce the number of points a little bit. And then I apply the find box operator. And as input value, the only information is the smallest size, the size of the smallest box, and the size of the largest box. And after providing those information, the box finder will localize all the boxes within this range. And this is what I would like to show you here. So this is the first scene. I can show you also some more scenes. So there's an algorithm that takes about 500 milliseconds. Obviously, depending on how many points are available and how many boxes needs to be found, it can be faster or slower. And some more examples. So this one here. This one here. And finally, the last example. Okay, this obviously results are not as expected. And the reason for it is there's one parameter which needs to be set in case that boxes are very close together, because and this is the max gap. This parameter controls the distance or the gaps which defines what is a 3D edge and what is not a 3D edge. Because in 3D point clouds, often you have to handle invalid points. And such invalid points, as you can see here, for instance, probably can have an impact on the 3D edge extraction. And this can be, what is allowed can be controlled by this parameter here. And if we set this a little bit lower, then results are as the following. Oh, there's something not as expected. So there has been changed something. I don't know exactly what. Yeah, now it is working. So it was still a little bit too large, because the two boxes are very close together, and therefore 8 pixels is still rather large and could be also be smaller. There's also a tool in order to inspect it. So we can also have a look at it. So over here, you see with 7, you can see very well the edges, but if this is too large here, the edges are vanishing. Okay, this is the box finder. Let's have a look at some other technologies like the surface-based matching. So the surface-based matching is a very powerful tool, and it is very flexible because it can cover a large range of different kind of objects. For instance, this one here. So in case of very noisy scenes, this one here, it's a scene acquired by a times of flight camera. First of all here, the model is extracted based on a template image. And then, I'll show it to you. So this is the model extracted by a template image. So the blue one are the point coordinates. The magenta one are the normal directions. So this is the model. And then we will have a look at the scene. So I will increase a little bit the window. Just this one here. And you see it is very of a low resolution and it's very noisy. So if you would not have the texture information by eye, it is very difficult to identify the objects in this point cloud. And this works, however, very robustly in HALCON. So I will show you some more scenes. Also this one here in 46 milliseconds. So it is also very fast. In order to verify that the objects are found correctly, I provided also the intensity image right here. This here is not available in the point cloud. It is only available in the intensity image. Therefore, obviously, this cannot be found. Here, the confidence value is very low, and therefore, the reconstruction is not perfect. More example, also this one here. Very noisy. And here, objects can also overlay. This is also okay. And this is the last one. So HALCON cannot only cover difficult settings in terms of noise and low resolution, but HALCON has also the possibility in order to get to take into account small features of objects in order to increase the robustness. For instance, here you say this object here, it is symmetric. It is almost symmetric. So the symmetry is disturbed only by those two holes. And usually the holes does not have any 3D information because usually they are missing information with respect to surface information. And therefore, however, you can use these, let's say, non-information nevertheless in order to increase the robustness of the matching results. And this is working as follows. So you, first of all, you will set the train surf similar poses to true in the offline step. And that this is all what you need to do. And then you just press F5 and you will see, okay, this is without this parameter, and this is with setting this parameter to true. And you will see, okay, this is a case where in both cases it worked well, this as well. And let's come to the next one. And here's the first example where the symmetry was not correctly because there are too much missing information. Here's another gap and so on. But with having this feature on, the robustness is increased perceptibly. Some more example, this one here. And another example. And this is what HALCON's surface-based matching does. you have the possibility to use all this flexibility in order to tune the surface-based batching, the point cloud batching for your application. And HALCON and robotic does not only address use cases such as bin picking, so you need to localize the object, but there are also some other edge cases, and one of these edge cases I would like to show. And this one is the following, and it is this one here. You have, let's assume you are in the factory hall. The factory hall is covered by a cart. And the robot, the autonomous robot, knows according to the cart where to go. But when arriving to the shelf, for instance, the information of the cart may be not enough. So there are some advanced algorithms required in order to improve the accuracy of the position, because the bin probably is also a little bit shifted and not exactly on the position where it should be. And therefore, you can also use the data code reader of HALCON in order to estimate the 3D transform that the robot will use in order to approach the bin, the shelf, very accurately. And this is what I would like to show in a simulation done in HALCON or in HDevelop. It's a prototype simulation. So it's the following. So here's the robot. Here's the shelf. And here you can see the results. This is the transform that is estimated. So the robot now approaches to this shelf here, and instantly the transform is updated. And the closer the robot comes, you see that the set C distance is also becoming closer and closer. And this is how you can use also data codes, for instance, in order to estimate a 3D pose. And now you can see how good the data code reader performs, because now we are almost out of focus. Let's wait maybe some few seconds. So here we see the data code is completely out of focus, but it is still read correctly. So this concludes this presentation. You see, there are many different kind of applications that can be covered by HALCON, and that have an attribute to the vision-based robotics in the industrial situations. If you have any question, I look forward to respond to answer to those questions.
So thank you very much, Luisa. There is a question. You introduced pick and place use cases based on 2D images and based on 3D images. Do you consider 2D and 3D images rather complementary or exclusive?
I consider them rather complementary, because depending on the situation, probably the requirement is to have a most cost-effective setup. And in such cases, 2D images needs to be considered as well. And then there are, however, also situations where 2D images does not have enough information in order to solve the application robustly, you know, to meet the requirements with respect to robustness. And this is the situation where 3D images are required. And then, however, there's the situation where 2D images and 3D images have not an additive value, but they are multiplying each cell. So you can use the advantage of 2D information and the advantage of 3D information, combine them together, and then use the combined information in order to increase the robustness of your of the vision part of your robotic application. And this is also the case what HALCON does. For instance, the edge-supported surface-based matching combines the 2D information and the 3D information, the edge information, in order to increase the robustness. And I think especially also with respect to deep learning approaches, and also that the trend that is seeing that more and more color information are available also in 3D sensors, 2D images combined with 3D information will become more and more important.
Mm-hmm. Wow, thanks. There's another one. Does HALCON also support algorithms for grasping objects of unknown shape?
Like you have seen before. it is possible to localize also or to estimate also the 3D transform also in case that you do not have any information about the shape of the object. So it's basically based on rule-based algorithms, on segmentation of the CMAP and the point cloud and so on. And there are also customers in the field who do this. Currently, however, we are working on an approach which means how to use deep learning together with the rule-based algorithm, because the idea is rule-based algorithm has some advantages, and 3D algorithm has also deep learning algorithm has also some advantages. And you can combine those two advantages in order to increase the robustness, the speed, and the results further. And yes, in this scope, we are working also, obviously, to improve the algorithm that are required to find objects with unknown shape.
Okay, nice. Thank you.